It is almost guaranteed that you get long unpronounceable sequences of consonants like shown here. And how do you enunciate the difference between lowercase and uppercase symbols? Yodeling? Hit points. The maximum hit points is stored as a 7-bit integer. Value 16 is the normal amount you start with. The game doesn't prevent you from giving yourself less HP though. However, the value should always be at least 4, or otherwise there will be rendering glitches. Value 0 means that Orpheus dies and there's nothing you can do. No amount of continues or retries will let him resume journey. Now, what about the biggest possible value? When I was a teenager, to save the progress in a video game, you had to write down a password using a pen and paper. In this series, we crack how these passwords worked. Battle of Olympus tells the tale of Orpheus, who travels through ancient Greece, meeting various townfolks, battling terrible monsters, negotiating business with gods, in his quest to free his lover, Helene, from her kidnapper, who was no less than Hades, the god of the underworld. But is that which I saw, that which I thought that I saw, includes password feature? The password input screen in Battle of Olympus looks like this. This is the list of symbols on the screen. Let's remove the arrows and the end because those were user interface tools and not part of the password. We are left with these 64 symbols. The Japanese version of the game likewise had 64 symbols, but quite different than the USA and European versions did. In canon, these passwords are words of God. The only way to get a password is to talk to a god and to write down what they say.
I will give you words of God. Write them down so that you do not forget them.
And then he will say something along the lines of Actually, no. In the Japanese version, the hero and heroine names given by the player are shorter than in the English versions, so the passwords are shorter. Now let's compare this to the English version.
Hear the word of the gods. Don't forget it.
And then he gives you something like this. Remember, in canon, this is supposed to be spoken aloud. If you get lucky, you may get a password that does not include any special symbols, only alphabets, but there are way more consonants than vowels in English. It is almost guaranteed that you get long unpronounceable sequences of consonants like shown here. And how do you enunciate the difference between lowercase and uppercase symbols? Yodeling? How do you yodel consonants? I mean, there are passwords that look perfectly good, but these are extremely, extremely unlikely to occur in the game. Here is one with all uppercase, one with all lowercase, and one with both. This one is not pronounceable, it has no letters at all. I felt like including it. My point is that the international English releases of the game required a lot more suspension of disbelief than the original Japanese version did when it comes to the so-called words of gods. I could probably find and speak a lot more about the differences between the Japanese and the English versions of the game. Maybe one day I might do a detailed comparison web page like I did for Simon's Quest. Would be fun. Lots of time could be spent easily. But I digress. The passwords can be made from 64 different symbols. This means that the passwords consist of 6-bit symbols. Why? Because 64 is what you get when you calculate 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. That is, 2 raised to the 6th power. A bit is something that can have two different values, 0 or 1. Each of these 2s is 1 bit. We have 6 2s, that is 6 bits. When you tack 6 bits together, you can have 64 different values. Each password symbol can have 64 different values, so each password symbol carries exactly 6 bits worth information. On the screen is an example password. We can count that the password is 26 letters long. Now seasoned veterans immediately suspect Base64. Base64 is a data encoding scheme that crams 8-bit data into 6-bit symbols, and we have covered it many times in previous episodes, for example Season 1 Episode 10, The Guardian Legend. Let's do some math. 26 symbols multiplied by 6 bits means that the password contains 156 bits of data. 156 divided by 8 is 19 and half. Huh, I guess this game does not use Base64 after all. Let's do a little exploration. This is the assembler code from the actual game. The function shown here generates a password. One moment, please. I will quickly translate this code into some Python code for analysis. I see. So it works like this. The password is divided essentially into four sections, illustrated on the screen. The very first slot of the password contains a random number. The middle section, spanning from the third slot to the penultimate slot, contains a bitstream. This bitstream stores the game data, such as the boy name, the girl name, and the number of olives collected. The second slot contains a checksum of the bitstream. All of above is encrypted using a fixed key, and the final slot contains a checksum of everything before it. This is how the data is laid out in the bitstream. It's easiest to read if we start from the end rather than from the beginning. There's flags starting from bit 0 until bit 27, immediately followed by the HP max bit 0 until bit 6, then the girl's name, then the boy name, and so on. Here is another chart that shows in detail which byte each data item comes from, for reference. Anyway, here is pseudocode for how the bitstream is essentially constructed. First, we made a 138-bit integer by concatenating all the data items. Then, this 138-bit integer is saved into the password slots in units of 6 bits. The game doesn't actually deal with 138-bit integers, and there are not many programming languages that do either, so here is another version of the bitstream constructing algorithm that works in units of 1 bit, just like the game does. It's really surprisingly simple. Now the encryption method. Once all but the final slot have been populated, the game encrypts the first 25 slots. This involves 3 steps. First, all slots are XORed with the preceding slot's value. Then a magic value is added to each slot. There are 4 magic values, and the loop cycles between these 4. And finally each slot is ANDed with 63 to keep only the 6 lowest bits. These 3 steps can of course be combined into a single expression. Then the checksums. There are 2 checksums. The checksum algorithm is pretty simple. The first checksum just adds together all the slots comprising the bitstream. This sum is then negated, and the lowest 6 bits are saved in the second slot. After encryption, the second checksum is calculated in exactly the same way as the first one, but from the entire password. In summary, the password is generated using 6 steps, which are listed here. The process starts from the top and ends at bottom. Now, if we want to decode a password, we have to reverse the steps, literally go from bottom to the top. First, the password symbols have to be converted into numeric values. Then, instead of calculating a checksum, we verify the checksum. This is done by adding together all the bytes and checking that the result is 0. In the third step, we undo the encryption by changing the plus into minus and reversing the order of operations. The same magic values still are used. Fourth, we check another checksum. Fifth, we don't actually need to generate a random number now. We can just skip step 5. The real step 5 is the decoding of the bitstream, which is pretty straightforward, at least if you can deal with 138-bit integers. So what is all of the data stored in the password? Let's start with the obvious, the boy and girl names. In the very beginning, when you start a new game, the game asks you to enter 2 names. One for the player character, the boy, the hero, who you will be controlling throughout the game. and one for the damsel in distress, the girl, the heroine, who will send you letters throughout the game and whom you will ultimately rescue if you are successful. The name can be 6 symbols long in the international versions and 4 symbols long in the Japanese version. You input the name using the same selection of symbols as in the password, 64 different symbols. But here is the issue. The game doesn't save the length of the name anywhere. How does the game know how long the name is? It uses the number 63 as an indicator for the end of the name. The number 63 happens to be the last symbol, the exclamation mark. Here's the kicker. If you manually enter an exclamation mark in the name, you will discover that the game cuts the name from that point. You can actually abuse this feature. The game does not allow you to enter a blank name, but if you enter a name that begins with an exclamation mark, then that's the same as if the player doesn't have a name at all. The Japanese version does not have this same problem. The name entry screen only has 62 symbols. You cannot enter symbol 63 manually. Then the salamander skin count. All numbers are fine, 0 to 31. The game accepts them and they don't cause any problems. However, the maximum you can get in the game ever is 20. If you have over 20 and try to get one more, nothing happens. The fire shield vendor only checks if you have at least 20, but she does not change the number you have. So the only way to get a number bigger than 20 is by using a custom password. The number of olives is coded in BCD. This means that there's a 1s digit and a 10s digit. Both digits normally vary from 0 to 9, but nothing prevents you from putting a value like 13 there. If you place a value like 13 in the low byte, the game actually corrects that and moves the extra 10 over to the 10s digit. If you place a high value in the 10s digit, then the game does not correct that. Instead, it renders 10 as a question mark, 11 as an exclamation mark, 12 as a period, and so on. Hit points. The maximum hit points is stored as a 7-bit integer. Value 16 is the normal amount you start with. The game doesn't prevent you from giving yourself less HP though. However, the value should always be at least 4, or otherwise there will be rendering glitches. Value 0 means that Orpheus dies and there's nothing you can do. No amount of continues or retries will let him resume journey. Now, what about the biggest possible value? Playing normally, you can increase your maximum hit points by collecting ambrosia, food of gods in the Greek mythology. Each ambrosia gives you plus 8, up to a maximum of 56. There are 5 ambrosias in the game, one in Peloponnesus, one in Laconia, one in Phthia, one in Argolis, and one in Phrygia. So in fact, the maximum HP you can legally attain is indeed 56. If you have 56 hit points or more, and you still try to pick up an ambrosia, the game gives you absolutely nothing. Using a password, 127 is the biggest number you can give, and it works just fine as you can see. However, what if you have the golden apple? The golden apple immediately doubles Orpheus's HP, but it causes the HP bar to be rendered half length to compensate. It also doubles the effect of any subsecutive ambrosia. If you have the golden apple, the maximum HP you can legally attain is 112. However, if you use a password to get yourself 124 hit points without the golden apple, and then you pick up the golden apple, you will actually have a whopping 248 hit points maximum, as long as you don't reset the game. But if you then save the game using a password, reset and reload, you will find the HP maximum decreased to 120, less than you had before, because only the lowest 7 bits were saved. There is not much to be said about the zero padding. The game only puts there number 0. You can put there any value between 0 and 3. The game doesn't care. It doesn't affect gameplay in any way whatsoever. Then, the game status flags. There are 40 flags in total, although 5 of those bits are unused. The password may include any combination of these flags. The game does not validate them. For example, it's possible to have all items, but still indicated that you never visited Zeus. Or your password may indicate that you have already beaten Hades. Here's what happens if you enter Hades' temple and Hades has already been beaten. Those who have played the game will recognize that the music is not what should normally be playing here. And then the game data stores the world region where you last acquired the words of God. The world region is a 4-bit integer, that is, it has 16 possible values. These values are Arcadia, Attike, Argolis, Peloponnesos, Laconia, Theia, Crete, Phrygia, and the first region of Tartarus. Wait a minute, that was only 9 values so far. Where are the rest? Value 9 takes you to the second region of Tartarus, but riding dolphin. Value 10 takes you to the third region of Tartarus, but the scrolling is broken. Value 11 takes you to Hades' temple, but you are riding dolphin and you cannot exit the room. Value 12 glitches for a moment, then takes you to Theia, plays the ocarina sound, and the game is frozen. Value 13 takes you to the third region of Tartarus, plays the title music, and the game is frozen. In the PAL version, this just produces a black screen. Value 14 gets you a black screen, and the CPU freezes shortly thereafter. Value 15 gets you a pink screen, and the CPU freezes shortly thereafter. And that's pretty much the whole mystery uncovered. In the next episode, we will take a look at another game with a grid-type password. By the way, efficient SIMD code always fascinates me. This is a small function that validates a Battle of Olympus password written in C++. On the right side, it is shown how this validation can be performed in x86 assembler without a single loop. I find this very fascinating. Especially the second loop, which does the decryption. It is reduced into just 4 instructions. For comparison, here is a version done without SIMD instructions. Thank you for watching. Be well and see you next time. Bye!